In the late 1800s, Abraham Miller moved to South Alabama and married into the Lacoste family, who were French immigrants trained as potters. Abraham learned the trade and passed it down to his son, who passed it down to his son, who passed it down to, well, you get the point. The family moved to Bibb County decades ago, and today, Eric and Steve Miller are the fifth and sixth generations carrying on the family tradition of turning Alabama clay into beautiful stoneware creations.
This pile of Alabama clay soil is destined for a greater purpose. For over 150 years, descendants of the Miller family have been digging up dirt and turning it into beautiful pieces of stoneware pottery.
We go dig our clay back in Perry County, where we've turned over there since 1880. We got a pit over there, dig it from that pit, bring it over here with a shovel. Then I will shovel it in the mill.
From the mill, the clay goes through a filter machine to remove sticks and rocks. And then it's put into a pug mill to remove air pockets.
Gotta have a solid, no air piece of clay to turn a piece. Then I'll put it on the wheel, make a piece.
And in what feels like the blink of an eye, the fifth generation potter has turned that chunk of clay into a pitcher.
When you get over 20 pounds of clay, nobody realizes but a potter how much pressure and muscles you have to put into that piece to make it rise.
The father-son team of Eric and Steve Miller complete every step of the process by hand, including dipping the pieces in a glaze and firing them in a kiln.
Creating something by hand, I mean, it's almost like a child. I mean, you've created this piece, and you know, you have to tend to it, and you know, and you're hoping it's going to come out well. It's just a good feeling to have the piece.
At one time, the Miller's Pottery Shop in Brent churned out thousands of pieces every year. Now, Eric and Steve, along with their cousin Alan Ham, keep the pottery tradition alive by fulfilling special orders and offering their work as collectibles at various art galleries, including Black Belt Treasures in Camden.
Another potter may create a bowl, but it's not going to look anything like one that Eric or Steve or Alan make, because it's a part of a cultural tradition of folk art that's been passed from one generation to another. It's not something they've learned in a classroom. It's something they've taught themselves.
There are plenty of utilitarian pieces to choose from, like vases, flower pots, and churns. But when you take a gander at some of their most unique pottery pieces, they'll actually look right back at you.
There is a growing appreciation for those decorative art pieces, like the devil jug. There are those who just think that it's the strangest thing they've ever seen and don't understand why anyone would create such an item. But then there are others that understand that those jugs have a long history in folk art and folk pottery.
Whether you buy it as art or want a piece to use in your home kitchen, the Millers are happy there's still a demand for their pottery, and that they get to carry on the family tradition.
I could make a piece on the wheel over there when I was 8 years up. And my son, he's been watching, and he's been messing with it since he was 5, 6, 8 years up. So it's being around it. That's how come it was handed down through the generations. They was being at the pottery, you know, and watching their father work. And that's how you learn it, watching and doing it.
There used to be potters in every town, and you know, it's a dying art, and to keep that tradition alive is it's a great feeling, you know. I mean, it's a lot of labor-intensive work, and not a whole lot of money in it per se, but we're keeping it alive.
Along with being sold at art galleries, Miller's Pottery is available for purchase from their shop off Alabama Highway 5 in Brent. You can also find their contact information by searching for Miller's Pottery on Facebook. When Simply Southern continues, lace up your boots and put on your hard hat. We're going to school, forestry school.
Wear long pants, long sleeve shirts, and closed-toed shoes. Don't be ticked. Use repellents with 20% DEET on skin and 0.5% permethrin on gear and clothing. Don't be ticked. Avoid sitting on rotten logs or stumps. Don't be ticked. Protect yourself from serious tick-borne illnesses and seek timely treatment to prevent long-term problems. No hunters were angered in the making of this film.
And now, an Alabama tourism spotlight from Sweet Home, Alabama. Occupying an entire city block in Demopolis, the Gainswood Mansion is a unique example of antebellum architecture. Nathan Bryan Whitfield served as his own architect as he built the Greek Revival home between 1843 and 1861. Considered one of Alabama's finest neoclassical houses, the home's exterior reveals Doric columns on all four sides. Inside, Corinthian and Ionic columns border the home's massive rooms, which are lavishly adorned with furnishings and artwork from the Whitfield family. The Alabama Historical Commission now operates the property as a historic home museum. For your next adventure, go online to alabama.travel.
We've been raising fish for 33 years. Our farm and the catfish farms in Hale County, in this area, have had a huge impact on the labor, offering jobs. It's been a big economic boom for West Alabama. Our family is fully invested in U.S. farm-raised catfish.